Hey guys, it's me Rahul, back with an amazing video for you guys. Have you guys heard about this thing called VirtualBox or VMware, which is a software on PC that allows you to install other operating system on your existing operating system like a piece of software. So that same is possible on your phone as well. So you can have your normal Android phone, and inside that phone you can install an app which has Android inside of it. And one of the cool things that this allows you to do is install rooted apps and use rooted Android inside your non-rooted phone. Sounds confusing, I know. Let me show you. So the app is called VMOS. There are two versions that you can download, VMOS and its Pro version. Basically, the Pro version offers more options, and that should be the one you should download. And yeah, both are free, but you need to pay for some extra features. I will get into it. So if you want to create a virtual machine, tap on the plus icon. Then it gives you two options. You can create a VM with Android 7.1 or Android 5.1. Those are the official ROMs available for you to install into this VM. But you can also install custom ROMs if you want to. There is an option for it. For this video, I'm going to be installing 7.1 ROM, and we can look at its option and what VMOS offers. When you boot into an official VM, it is a pure stock experience. There aren't any third-party apps or even Google apps. You need to enable it in the settings to use Google services. Other than that, it's a very stock-like, and it runs exceptionally well. We can try to play some games on it later. For now, let's check out some features that VMOS has. If you tap on this floating ball, you get a couple of options to capture a screenshot, exit out of VM, or switch to other VM. VM settings, minimize the VM, transfer the files from and to the native OS, and your navigation buttons. So let's dive into the settings and look at what each does. At the top, you can enable or disable root access. You need to create a VMOS account for that, and it is paid around $3.5 per month. Next option is to enable exposed framework to play around with exposed modules and things like that. Next is an option to enable Google services. You don't need a member account for that, it's free. Next one is resolution, in which you can set custom resolution for your VM. Next one is step counting magnification. For those who want to cheat on some step counting apps, they can use this functionality. Authority management helps you control what sensors that the VM can use, and there are some other options as well. And also you can set the refresh rate. So those are the main settings and features of VMOS. Let's boot into a VM and try to play a game. While playing, I will tell you what I think about this app and what you can use it for. Obviously, everything runs pretty smooth in this VM. There isn't any noticeable lag or anything like that, obviously. The reasons why someone would use this is for mainly two purposes. Either they want a test environment to test out apps and things like that, or to use root apps without rooting the entire device. But the problem with the latest version of VMOS is that it only lets you enable root option if you pay the member fee. I think a couple of months back, you could actually install rooted versions of virtual machines without paying a penny in VMOS. So that's my only problem with this app, but again, they need to make money somehow, and I feel this is totally fair. So that's been it. Check it out if you want to play around with virtual machines on your Android phone. So that's been it. Hope you guys liked this video. If you did, give this video a big thumbs up, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Goodbye.